Victoria Woodhull, Wall Street's first female broker. Opening a successful brokerage wasn't the whole plan. As Victoria later said, "I got into Wall Street not particularly because I wanted to be a broker, but because I wanted to plant the flag of the women's rebellion in the center of the continent." On May 14, 1870, Victoria used the profits from the brokerage to launch Woodhull and Claffin's Weekly, one of the country's first publications published by women. In 1871, Victoria became the first woman to address a congressional house committee. She argued that women should already have the right to vote, based on the 14th and 15th Amendment. Congress, as we know, didn't go for it. Undeterred from this setback, Victoria ran for President of the United States. In 1872, she was officially nominated by the Equal Rights Party, with Frederick Douglass, a civil rights activist and abolitionist, as her VP. She, of course, didn't win. Victoria played a pivotal role in carving a place for women in investing. She and her sister gave women an opportunity to take control and manage their finances in a time where it was largely unheard of. Let's go, Victoria!